There's this great mindfulness movement now, and I think that's a nice way of seeing it. Some people call it a mindfulness craze. I don't want to be that uncharitable, because clearly a lot of people are getting benefit. And so it's become very popular. It's in the media, it's everywhere, being scientifically studied, and the practical applications in the business world and so forth and so on are being very much highlighted. It looks like it is something of a fad, and it's also coming under severe criticism by people who are not unintelligent. I've read one article after another that's saying, you know, this is not just a bowl of cherries, this has some serious downside to it. And so the question can come, well, what's after mindfulness? And here's my answer. I'm going to catch you by surprise, I think. Buddhist mindfulness. Because what we have right now is a definition of mindfulness that has never been Buddhist, is not Buddhist now, and will not be tomorrow. Just calling something Buddhist doesn't make it Buddhist. And if you make up your own definition of mindfulness that is nowhere to be found in any Buddhist tradition or in any of the teachings of the Buddha himself, then it's illegitimate to call it Buddhist just because you like it, or maybe it's a good marketing tool. So here's a definition that is, as I say, it's a psychological definition. And mindfulness is a moment-to-moment presence of mind, an attentiveness to whatever is arising in the field of your experience, and attending to it closely but without judgment. And just being present with whatever's happening here and now. And whatever it is, just being present. That's a nice definition. There's no, show me any source older than 50 years old in the Buddhist tradition that says that's a definition of mindfulness. And I can tell you it's not to be found, because it's not a Buddhist definition. It's a definition that's inspired by some people who like Buddhism, or it's inspired by extremely watered down versions of Vipassana. But I can tell you the Buddhist definition of mindfulness, which is entirely different. And it's not sectarian. It's actually everywhere by scholars who know how to study well. Is the Buddhist version of mindfulness is I'm now familiar with you, for example. I'm not shocked. Who are you? A bit of familiarity. So I maintain a flow of awareness of you, and maintaining that flow of attention, it's voluntary, because I'm focusing on you, your questions, your body language, your facial expression. I'm bearing you in mind. I'm holding you in mind. I'm sustaining this flow of voluntary attention without distraction and without forgetfulness. That's mindfulness. I am being mindful of you. Now, mindfulness can be retrospective. I remember my address. That's retrospective mindfulness, because the core Buddhist meaning of mindfulness is recollection, as in bearing in mind. Am I bearing in mind my address? Yes, I can tell you. If I'm practicing mindfulness of breathing, I'm bearing in mind the in and out flow of the breath from moment to moment. But I can also bear in mind, I need to leave here at 6 o'clock to go off and give a lecture. I need to be ready at 6 to go out the door. And I'm going to bear that in mind, and that's prospective memory. So mindfulness, this is rich mindfulness. And you can use this in the classroom, in the business room. You can use this to achieve enlightenment. It's useful at all times. And so really developing attention skills, metacognitive skills, and enriching and refining discerning mindfulness. And discerning mindfulness is, as I'm observing my own way of speaking and my own mind, seeing the type of thoughts and desires, intentions and so forth arising, Buddhist mindfulness is discerning mindfulness. And we recognize which ways of speaking, physically behaving and using the mind, which are wholesome, which are conducive to my own and others' well-being, which are afflictive, toxic, harmful to myself and others. And then Buddhist mindfulness entails discerningly recognizing, this is wholesome, this is unwholesome, and then do the sensible thing. Follow that which is wholesome, and then release as much as you can the unwholesome. That's not being judgmental, it's being wise and discerning, and often the wisdom and the discernment is completely left out in the modern mindfulness movement. It's left out of ethics, it's left out of Buddhist worldview, it's left out of Buddhist way of life, and therefore it's not Buddhist. Not even by its definition, it's actually not Buddhist at all.